Good morning, fans, PrivateerFX. Coming at you guys, 22 August here. It's Wednesday. Had some movement last night again. Late Europe, the New Yorkers did some things. Let's go to ES to start. We had some nice sales there above 70. We did not catch, we did not buy any of those back below 50. We're core short. We're just looking at this bar here saying, wow. Confirmed already with a lower low. It was really just pure luck when you ping the high like that. That is just a gift from the Magi, as some religious folk might say. But of course, short S&P's pretty easy stop now. Just plunk it right up there at 75, and if you get done, just gonna have to rethink this trade. But for now, of course, short, looking for a move down here to 2803. Powell obviously in Jackson Hole tomorrow, as we talked about yesterday. So see how this goes. Euro, we faded euros last night. Our average is not great. We're short at 75. I thought we would get more of a move lower here in Asia, but what we've had is basically no move. So I've actually cut this position in half, and feels too much like, oh man, you're a genius. Ping the high in S&Ps, you think you're going to ping the high in euros. So, no, I'm a little bit more worried about this, so I just cut it in half, because we're also short Aussie as well. Aussie, we've been playing short, so our average is much better. And we sold 67s last night, we bought 50s, we sold 58s, so we're short into the high 80s. This is still sell on rally, and I just feel more comfortable with it than euro. I don't know why, but so core short Aussie, core short euro, core short S&Ps. As far as new trades today, this Swiss is a little bit hard to believe, but here we are. 97.54 is the 200 day. This will be a bounce. This will be supportive first time down. So it's 100 points away. God knows. We've got to put it in the book just in case something silly happens. We'll be interested to buy some dollar Swiss down here. Euro Swiss is doing nothing. All the yen crosses are kind of tickety-tocketing at the high. This doesn't make a lot of sense to me with the move in S&Ps last night. So I'm going to be very, very careful. Normally I'd be buying through these highs here on sort of a momentum deal. 142.66, but I am not going to do that today. And we're just going to sit back and be patient, deal with our Aussie and Euros for now. New trades are looking a little bit sparse, I have to say. I don't want to force this. Let's just check the calendar. Let's see what kind of story we're going to get today. Wednesday the 22nd. Retail sales in Canada. Tonight. So, retail sales in Canada, a tough one. Who really cares about retail sales as well? Dollar CAD is just playing on the bottom end of its range. Let's not force it. No trade there. The last chart I guess we should show is this. This bar got me excited last night. Had a little bit of follow through down to 90. I don't mind selling cable if we get a move down towards 90. I have this distinct feeling the first move is going to be higher and we're going to make a mar- marginal new high in cable. It just seems a little bit too easy. PrivateerFX is selling euros, selling Aussie. We did not hit the bid in cable, but I'm sure many people did. But we're lurking now. We haven't done what really needs to be done. We needed more of an impetuous move lower, which we didn't get. But if we do print a new high here and then do get back through 90, I think you can buy dollars again. Again, the theory being that the minutes tonight are going to be neutral to hawkish. I'm not saying too much. Nothing much has changed. But more importantly, we're expecting Powell and the gang to be hawkish at Jackson Hole. And this will turn the boat and people will dive back into buying dollars again. Quickly on Bitcoin, big move up. You can see last night, not sure why that is. We have some lonely, lonely bids down there below 5,000. But we are core long, so we're not too disappointed. And we don't want to get too greedy. Same strategies are in play. We're waiting for this 5,000 break, which may never happen now. And we're just marching forward our core longs. The next move for us in Bitcoin might be a break trade up through 8,400. So again, patience, patience, patience here. If you look at her closely, she's still on her knees. Come on, look at her. Lower highs, lower highs, lower highs. Now we have this line in the sand here. It's almost like she just wants it tested. And my feeling is it will get tested again. So patience. But we got a nice little up move in Bitcoin last night. So news for the folks. That's all I really got here. We're just going to manage what we've got. Again, we're core short spoos, euros, and Aussie. Very cautious on this euro position. And we'll just be patient and see what comes. Good luck out there, people. I will flash up some tweets if I get any inspiration during the day. Ciao.